How's it going, everyone? And welcome back to the Taco Tech Talk channel. And today, I just want to talk about the Galaxy Tab S7 Plus after a week's worth of use. So I want to give you guys some my thoughts and my how it's been with the display, performance, some battery life, and some other features. And just a quick disclaimer, this is my first Android tablet. And the reason it's my first one is because, one, it's the first time I can afford one. And two, I truly think this is the best tablet you could possibly get as far as Android goes. There's always been the iPad Pros and the iPad Airs, but I'm not an Apple guy. I'm more Android, so this is the first time I've ever felt like this is the best time to get a tablet. So let's get into why I think it is. So after a week of use, how's the display? In a word, truly amazing. That's two words. I lied to you, but it's truly amazing. It truly is amazing how amazing the display is. It's quick because of the refresh rate, 120 hertz. It is nice and colorful. It's big. The screen aspect ratio at first I was a little questionable, but for watching movies and shows, it's perfectly fine. It's the perfect aspect ratio. There's like barely any black bars. Only time I see black bars is on YouTube videos when they have the different aspect ratio for like the phones. So like, it looks a little bit different on here, but otherwise, not bad. It looks amazing. Quality is great. The refresh rate is great. Display is in solid A+. I love it. Performance-wise, I haven't pushed the tablet to its limits yet. Only thing I have used for as far as performance to really push it, is just a little bit of gaming. A little bit of gaming and some light multitasking. I haven't done anything crazy with it. Like, I haven't gone extensively with Dex either, so I can't give you my opinion on that yet. Hopefully give you that opinion and full review coming later on this month, or actually later on in October, because I need more time to test out all the kinks on the tablet. But performance wise, this thing is a nice solid beast. It's got 6 gigs of RAM and the Snapdragon 865 Plus. Really, really gives it a nice combo. I know you can get the 8 gigs of RAM, but I only got 6 gigs of RAM. So, and I haven't had an issue with that. So I truly haven't had one. I'm able to see how much RAM I'm using, and currently right now we're actually only using 3.1 out of 6, which is not bad. So I have still half of the RAM to still use up. So, and I don't think I'll ever end up using that much RAM. On my phone I have 8 gigs of RAM, and most of the time the highest I get to is like 5 or sometimes 6, but I don't plan on using it like that extensively. And that's because I forget to close apps as well, so, and I usually close my apps right away. But yeah, performance-wise, this thing is a beast. The gaming is great. I've tried Xbox game streaming, played some GTA, played some FIFA, and both worked really well. Only thing I found was that the resolution for the games, they stream at 720p for some reason. And it kind of sucks, because considering the display is really sharp, it's 1440p, and you only get 720p at Xbox game streaming. It's sad to see, but nothing you can do about that. At least the games run. You could never run an Xbox game on here before, right? And now you can with the Xbox game streaming, and that's just awesome that you can do that. Next I want to talk about is note-taking. So note-taking is really good on this. That's why the S Pen is such a good tool. I never thought I'd love the S Pen. I never thought I'd ever need an S Pen, actually, because I've always had a Galaxy S Series phone and never a Note Series phone. I'm getting a Note Series phone next time I upgrade. But the pen is so nice to take notes on. The latency of 9 millimeters or 9 milliseconds, I believe, is so good. It feels like you're just writing on magical paper. As soon as you touch the pen and you start to write or start to draw, it works perfect. It just feels so natural and so good. I love what they've done with it. And with it being my first S Pen, I think it set the bar high. The tablet itself set the bar high. While we're on the topic of the S Pen and note-taking, writing out notes is on the keyboard, because I have the keyboard cover as well. It's a little meh. It's nice. It's not backlit, which is a nice little, it's a complaint, but I have a laptop that doesn't have a backlit keyboard as well, so I'm kind of used to that. But being a backlit should be, would be a nice pro, addition to it, considering how much you're paying for it. But the keyboard itself is nice. But the touchpad is really kind of meh. It's kind of janky. It's not as responsive as you would think. And in fact, using the whole keyboard on the tablet software, it's not like a regular laptop. There's some things that aren't optimized perfectly, like double clicking sometimes opens the app, clicking once sometimes opens the app, and it's just, you know, the software needs to be optimized for it to be used best with the keyboard. And that goes the same thing with using on wireless or on DeX mode. Sometimes the icons need two clicks, sometimes they need one click, and you can't even right click on some things. Like I try to, you know how you can right click to get more settings and options? You can't on Samsung DeX, or you can't on Android tablet mode. And it's just a little annoying because you would expect it to run like a regular laptop, right? But unfortunately it doesn't, and I don't know how like how iPads do it, but I just know right now that Samsung and Android itself is just isn't optimized for that. And it's a little annoying, but it's a little issue we can live with until they can hopefully figure it out. But that's that on note taking. Now I want to talk about the battery life. The battery on this has been really good in my opinion. I just learned a new feature. It's called Protect Battery, I believe, where you're able to set your battery max to 85%. So that it seems like your battery is like dying on you and or at full charge when you're charging it, but it'll only reach 85%. That way you can keep maximize your battery's long-term, you know, use and have it last forever or for a longer time. But I just turned that on today actually, and I just learned that today actually too. So something really neat about there. I wish they added it to the phones because I tried to look it on my S10 and I don't have that, but that's a really cool feature that you can do that with that. I also turn off fast charging, just test it out, because people say don't charge things overnight, but I'm gonna charge this overnight. Like, it's just so convenient just to plug it in at night before you go to bed. And turning that off will just make it even better to, you know, reduce stress on the battery. But battery has been great. I've gone anywhere from 5 to 6 hours of screen on time, and the battery has lasted me all day. So I unplug it at like 7 a.m. when I wake up and go all the way to like 10 or 11 at night and still have battery left. Not much, like 10% left, but still enough to get you the whole day, which is great. That's awesome, honestly. I never expected that. My phone sometimes makes it to only like 6 or 7 in the afternoon. Granted, it's a year old, but that's a different story. So the battery on this is amazing. At first, when I first unboxed it, it was a little bad. Like I only got like 3 or 4 hours of screen on time, and by the end of the day, I was at like 20% already. So that just has to do again with the battery being optimized to your usage, and you know, it's brand new, so give it some time to adjust. And then I just want to touch real quick, I know I already mentioned it a little bit, but wireless DeX and some other features on here. Wireless DeX I have not extensively used yet. I know it's like a laptop, Windows type experience, and I haven't fully used it yet, but for my first couple times that I've used it, it's been not bad. There's still some optimization that needs to be done with a lot of the software as far as Android and some of the other apps. But otherwise, it seems like something that could be promising. I haven't yet pushed it to its limits and tried it out extensively, like I said, but hopefully for the full review, I'll be able to give you a better opinion and better thoughts on it. But for now, wireless DeX. I haven't used that either, but Samsung DeX, it looks promising. That's what I gotta say. It looks promising. I'm yet to extensively use it still. Other features that can be a little annoying is some apps like Instagram just don't work on tablets. They work, but you have to use them in portrait mode. And that goes for other apps too. They're forced to be used in portrait mode, and it just means you have to flip the tablet in portrait mode and use it like that. It can be annoying because sometimes you have the tablet landscape like this, like I have it now, and then you have to force yourself to use it like this, you know, in the middle of you being comfortable, even with the keyboard cover on. So, and then the keyboard itself, I already talked about that. I think you should definitely look into investing in it. If you're not going to use the keyboard, maybe just look for a book cover, just because the pen being hidden back here makes it so much easier for you to not to lose it. It's so nice just to have this little safekeeping flap here for your pen. It makes it so nice, and also reduce scratches on the back and keep your tablet a little bit safer than normal. I do plan on putting a screen protector on it just so that it can last me for about a year, 2 years without having scratches, then I'll take it off and then use it as normal. But besides that, let's talk about the cameras real quick. Cameras. Are you going to use your cameras on the tablet? Because I'm not. But I promise you that these tablets aren't that great. When I first started using them, they were very grainy. Like you could see all the grain everywhere. It's nice that they added them. It's very useful for like scanning documents. But for picture taking, I don't think it's going to be that amazing. I haven't yet used the front facing for Zoom yet, but just by looking at the quality, it looks like any other laptop to me, maybe just a little bit better too. But don't plan on using your tablet for video taking and photo taking. Use a smartphone for that, or use your own real camera for that. This definitely cannot replace any of those. This is just meant for like scanning notes. But otherwise, that's it on note taking. Hope you guys enjoyed. And oh, I just say note taking. That's it on the tablet. Hope you guys enjoyed. Leave your like, leave a comment, subscribe for more videos. Hope you guys found this video interesting and informative. My goal on this channel, guys, is to just give you guys as much honesty and possibly detail as I can, because I can't afford every tech that comes out, and clearly maybe you can't either. And so I want to help you buy products that will help you and will honestly just be worth the money, and not just go around buying money. Because some reviewers will buy a tablet or buy, you know, a product and use it for 2 weeks and give you a review, but then they don't use it anymore. So then that loses its some of its like value, you know, because you won't be able to know how it goes after and after. So I'm not a super techie nerd, but I do like tech, and I do like to review them and give you my thoughts on it. So hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you for watching, and peace out.